The interesting thing about the Immortal Hulk is that we find Bruce Banner and the Hulk in a situation we've never seen them in before.
I think what excites me the most about the Immortal Hulk run is that it is so different and yet so true to the essence of the character. This is not a Hulk that you've seen before, and yet it feels very much like the Hulk everybody kind of instinctively knows. That people who haven't seen any of the movies or television shows or any of the comics or anything, what little they know about the Hulk, this is that Hulk. Just distilled down to its quintessential essence, and it's going to be, I think, very different from any other book that we're publishing, any other book that anybody is publishing.
Fans love the dark corners of the Marvel Universe. You know, there's so much evil lurking behind. Everybody loves a good villain or a good bad guy story. And while there are so many characters who play in that area of the Marvel Universe that ride the line between good and evil, the Hulk has been a character that we've never really seen in this situation. So to find Bruce, the Immortal Hulk, fighting these horrors in his own mind and in the Marvel Universe is just an amazing adventure that Al Ewing and Joe Bennett are going to take you on.
For the Immortal Hulk, we really wanted to treat it as a horror book in a way that it kind of hasn't been for a while. Myself, I was deliberately looking back at like the very first issues of the Hulk and back in the early 60s and taking my cue from like those first couple of issues where he's sort of a creature that comes with the night, with the darkness. He's this sort of unknowable monster in the heart of a good man. The question we're asking is, are we man? Are we monster? Are we both?